I met a man the other day. I wish I knew his name. His eyes, his mind, his heart spoke of untold promise. He reminded me of someone I once knew. A man of destiny. A man of belief. A man not unlike myself. Madam Toastmaster. Have you ever lost your way? Have you ever lost sight of who you are? Have you ever found yourself straying from the path you had chosen in life and found it difficult to find your way back? Albert Einstein once said, "A man who dreams is more powerful than the one who knows all the facts." 10 years ago, I believed in a dream. 10 years ago, I believed in who I was. 10 years ago, I made a new start. I believed in who I was, and I believed in where I was going. I said to myself, where am I really going? What is my inspiration in life? I said, I have a mission in life and I'm finding my way. And I took a big chance. I took a leap of faith. I said to myself, I must go with my heart. 2 weeks before my deadline, there were over 200 items on my snag list. People said, he will never do it. He will never make it happen. A friend of mine at that time said to me, how did you continue to believe? How did you believe that people would want to see what you had created? How did you keep going? And I said to myself, it's very simple really. It was the title of a movie, Field of Dreams. And a special line in that movie stood with me throughout this time. And the line was very simply, build it and they will come. Build it and they will come. Build it and they will come. You see, I had built a children's play centre, which I believed at that time, outshone the rest. And I said to myself and I said to my friend, I believe they will come. I believe most certainly people will come. And sure enough, they did. And they came in very, very big numbers. In our first 2 years, we had 50,000 children each year, accompanied by 20,000 to 30,000 adults. It was out of sight. It was out of mind. I had achieved everything that I had aspired to in my dream. We worked hard and I believed in what we were doing. I said to myself, this is my greatest achievement in life. And my only regret was that my father wasn't with me to experience it. But of course, you know, sometimes dreams become a reality and they don't last. And of course, after 2 years, the crash came and everything began to fall apart. The whole world fell asunder. Things that we knew, things that we believed in, were suddenly turned upside down. I found myself in a dilemma. But I continued to work and I continued to believe. I worked so hard, I almost forgot who I was. But a little voice in the back of my head remembered an old cowboy who once said, the secret of life is this, just one thing. Just stick with one thing and everything will be okay. The rest doesn't matter. So I stuck with that one thing. I worked and I believed. And I was asked to join a select number of business people who were either owners or managers in businesses to try and figure out how to work our way through difficult times. And the group asked me, can you explain what it is your business is all about in 5 sentences? And I thought for a few moments and I said, you know, I can do it in 4 words. We make magic memories. And they said, so what are you doing here? And I said very simply, I want to find the magic once again. At this time, an unusual thing occurred. My wife texted me with a funny line. It was from a movie as well. It was more a Rocky movie. And it simply said, every champion was once a contender who refused to give up. What a line. What a great line. What a very apt, well-chosen line for this very moment. And so, my friends, I say to you, I joined Toastmasters in November 2016, last year, with a sense of hope, with a sense of belief, not quite knowing what to expect. And you know something? I met some people. I made some friends. And I learned a very important lesson. You see, all of us here are a bit like Tesco. Every little bit helps. You see, I've learned that with a little bit of help from our friends, we can do almost anything. And here is the great truth in life. Dylan Thomas once wrote, "Do not go gentle into that good night. Old age should burn and rave at close of day. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. You may lose sight of who you are. You may lose sight of your dream. You may stray from the path and find it difficult to find your way back. But remember one thing. If you believe in yourself, if you believe in the dream, if you believe there is a light at the end of the tunnel, you will succeed, you will overcome, and you will find your field."